In this video, I want to talk about a weird error that I encountered while I was writing some UI tests. So the error message will look like this: Android view inflate exception, binary XML file line, and then some file line. And basically what it means, what Android Studio is trying to tell you is that there's something wrong with your layout file. But I want to show you why this particular issue is very tricky to catch when you're writing UI tests. So in front of me here, I have the application that I'm going to be writing a UI test for, just a simple app that displays some blog posts in a recycler view. So the thing I want you to notice here is that the app runs completely fine. So like the actual running of the application, nothing is wrong. So now what we're going to do is we're going to go and run the UI test that I was writing. And the issue is in place right now, so it'll fail. So don't worry about like what this UI test is doing if you don't know about UI tests. Even if you don't know yet how to write UI tests or anything, eventually as you get more experience as a developer, you will. So knowing about this issue is definitely going to help you. So notice that it fails. So right away it fails. If I click here and I scroll down, we see that the error is binary file line 26 failed to resolve attribute, blah, 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 blah. So now, typically when you see this error, what it means is there's something wrong with the layout file. You know that in like if you were to run an application and you see this error, it means that something is wrong in your layout. You've done something stupid. You've done something you aren't supposed to. Something is wrong in the layout XML file. So if we go into the XML layout file, which is going to be fragment list here, it says on line 26 down in the log. So if I go down to line 26, I just have a text view here. And at first glance, it seems like what could be wrong here? The only thing that it's kind of a little odd is maybe this action bar size thing. And this is why this issue is tricky to catch, because the app runs completely fine. This, for those of you who don't know what this is, the question mark ATTR action bar size is just a way to add the default action bar size to a view. So like, I believe this is equivalent to writing like, I think it's like 55 dp. I think it matches whatever the material design specs are, which I believe is 55 dp. It's somewhere between 58 dp, somewhere around there. I think it's 55. In general, all this does is if you write ATTR action bar size, it just inserts, you know, 55 dp or whatever the default action bar size is. And this has no issues when you actually run the application. But for some reason, when you're running tests, this causes it to fail. So if I was just to remove this and replace it with, you know, 55 dp, press shift F10 to rerun the test, the error will be gone, as you'll see in a second here. So there is instantiating the test. Gonna run the first one here, still running, green check mark, good, and then the other ones will run fine too. So it's kind of a weird error, especially because I think this is a pretty common thing to use that action bar, that default action bar size for views, because it's a quick and easy way to add, you know, 55 dp or whatever the default action bar size is without having to create a dimension in your dimensions file. So a pretty weird one. I just want to share it with you because, like I said, I wasted a lot of time on this because the problem was I had too many things. Like, I was trying to do too many new things at once, too many unknowns in the things that I was trying to do. So I wasn't able to like narrow it down to that. I was thinking, oh, well, the app runs, why would it be that? But turns out, some stupid little error. Anyway, hopefully this saves you some time. If you like the video, leave a comment below if you have any other kind of weird issues that you've encountered with Espresso. I've encountered many. I'll be curious to see what you have to say. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.